What it is, y'all, it's your old boy Pilk, and I'm coming back today with more Damachi. Now, we've got this new Memoria here, and I've gone ahead and maxed it out because, if you didn't know, let's just go ahead and just pull up the Memoria here. In essence, it's all parties, fire, water, and dark attack damage, plus 6% for 11 to 15, for turns 11 to 15. Now, when this is at base, it's 1%. But as you guys should already know, really, if you're going to use a Memoria, you need to max that Memoria out. Now, I've got 800 of the gems here, so I'm not really worried about... I got 20, but whatever. Cross that bridge when I come to it. It's 100 to max it out, so... Honestly, I've got enough here I can max out anything I really want and not have to worry about it. But if we pay attention to the art here, it's really, really interesting to me. So we got fire, water, and we got dark. Now, I see a lot of fire units. I see a lot of water units. I think there might be a dark unit or two in there, but I don't... I remember more of these units being fire and water. And once again, I could be wrong in this. But being that we're about 2 weeks away from the anniversary, the smart thing for Riot Flyer to do would be to drop a Memoria that's... I don't want to say hinting at what's coming, but that will be very useful for whatever team is coming. So, the first... section, the first part of the anniversary that we're getting, I'm willing to bet is either gonna be water, fire, or dark, and I think most likely dark. And let me kind of explain why here. So two years ago, our big team is water, kind of like the light team has been for the last year. Water dominated. Water absolutely just, I mean, absolutely annihilated everything. Now, water was the most insane team you could get, period. It was the best. Then obviously last year we got light. Then fire really has had a lot of love here and there. Fire was really, really good during the second anniversary, shortly after the third anniversary event. They got another really big buff when we got lead and all that stuff. So fire's had its day. Water's definitely had its day. Dark is a good team, but dark tends to be good and then get dethroned and then be good again and then get dethroned. And it just kind of goes back and forth like this, essentially. I don't want to say forever, but it goes back and forth for a very long time. Dark has been inconsistent, and I don't think Dark has had a really good representation during the anniversaries. We usually get Dark units like a couple times a year, namely during like December, during October, that other month, and things like that. But I can't think of an anniversary, maybe Grand Day, but I don't even think that, to be fair, where Dark really had its moment. And even Grand Day, I wouldn't count because that first anniversary event was nothing compared to the anniversaries we got afterwards. So, really, I'm willing to bet, willing to wager. Okay, so it is an extremely low-stakes wager, first of all, because I have enough items here that I can max out any of the other Memoria I need. I'm not really worried about it. But I'm willing to bet that Dark probably is going to get some major love during this coming anniversary. That's what I'm thinking. Now, the wise individual out there, if you're not sitting on 1,000 gems like I, or the better part of 1,000 gems like I am, the intelligent person's going to take a look at this and stop and wait and hold on. Because quite frankly, while I could be right, I could just as easily be wrong. And I'd love to tell you it's a 50-50 chance, but there's so many more elements out there. We're really talking about, I'm wagering that one of these three is going to be the one, and that's out of, what, 8-9 elements? So, you know, like, I could be right, I could be wrong, but I could be wrong way more than I could honestly be right. But as far as Riot Flyer goes, I just don't think it's prudent or intelligent for them to drop a Memoria that really is nothing to do with what's coming. It really doesn't make a huge amount of sense. So I kind of see this as maybe being their path going into the anniversary. But let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Now, honestly, the smart thing here to do would be to wait, don't max it out. When we get the anniversary, then max it out. But do make sure you pick up this Memoria, because that turn 11 to 15 is going to be so insanely critical. It really is that sweet spot that once you have everybody buffed up, you've done a couple of essays to do your debuffing, to do your buffing, to do whatever, and then you're going to start doing some major damage on those turns. Consider like Record Buster and things like that. So this, I think, is an excellent representation of what is coming, but once again, it's all speculation. I've got no proof. So if you agree or disagree, let me know how you feel in the comments section down below. I'm going to go forward. I'm hoping I'm right. But I am also, you know, obviously hedging my bets here a little bit, because if I need to max anything else out, I definitely can do that. But I really do like this Memoria, and I'm hoping that this is a good sign of what is to come. Like, comment, share, and I'll catch you guys for more Damachi Memoria Freeze coming up here really soon.